Greetings from Columbia, South Carolina and Dreher High School. It is your site for the Class 2A Duels Wrestling State Championships as the Emerald Vikings with a 17-1 record face off against the defending state champs, the Hawks of Hanahan High School with a 20-7 record. Hello everybody, I am Birch Antley. This is Bill Pierce, former head coach of the Emerald High School Yellow Jackets. And Bill, great matchup here today between Emerald and Hanahan.
Yeah, I think so. You got a returning champs.
Greetings from Columbia, South Carolina and Dreher High School, your site for the Class 2A Duels Wrestling State Championship as the Emerald Vikings 17-1 record take on the Hanahan Hawks, the defending state champs, with a 20-7 record. Hello, everybody. I am Birch Antley. This is Bill Pierce, former head coach at Irmo High School. Bill, great matchup here today between Hanahan and Emerald.
Yeah, Birch, I'm really looking forward to this match. You've got the defending state champs who are out here to keep their crown against an upstart program that had a really good regular season, finishing 17-1.
Well, the Emerald Vikings, this is their first ever appearance in the state championship. They've got a lot of great individual wrestlers on that squad. We caught up with their head coach, Andy Wright. We asked him moments ago what he thinks about this year's team and why they are so special.
I mean, it's a great fingerprint on the program and build success, and it'll draw attention to the program.
What is so special about this year's team?
They got a lot of heart, and they've came together as a family. Now, I think that's what's helped this team a whole lot.
What are you looking for out of your squad today besides competing well?
Just effort. I mean, as long as they give me everything they got, that's all I want.
Well, on the other side of the mat, the defending state champs from the lower country of South Carolina near Charleston, the Hanahan Hawks. They feature a lot of individual record holders and some state champions in the individual ranks for Hanahan, but they are one stellar team.
Yeah, Dennis Flores at 160 for Hanahan is a state champion last year at 145. And then they also have J.J. Johnson, who was a two-time state runner-up for the squad.
We caught up with their head coach, Durham Atkins, and we asked him, what makes this year's team so special?
It means about winning the title today. You know, we were fortunate enough to get here. Now we got to prove it. So it's a great day for Hanahan Wrestling. Hopefully we can come home with the state championship.
What makes this team so special this year?
This team's special because, we started off not so great. And we've gotten better, and the kids believe themselves. We set a goal to make it here to the state championship, and they've earned it the whole way. So this team's got a lot of heart.
And there you have it. We are moments away from the start of this 2A Duels Wrestling State Championship. Now let's catch up with the commissioner of the South Carolina High School League, Mr. Jerome Singleton. And Jerome, first off, what a beautiful location here at Dreher High School for this championship.
Absolutely, Birch. First, I'd like to begin by thanking Dreher High School and Principal Gene Sickelbauer and Athletic Director Mike DuBard and the Athletic Department, because they've done a fantastic job in helping us to set this up. And it just shows that our member schools are very interested in helping the league to be successful.
And also hats off to your Associate Commissioner Bruce Houillon for really working hard to put this all together, and he's got some great officials again this year.
I'm glad you brought that up. Bruce has taken this over for the last 2 years, and he's done a fantastic job of working this for. We used to have Roger Hazelman, who has since retired. Bruce stepped in and filled in the blanks, and I'm telling you, he's doing a fantastic job. I'm very appreciative of what he does and the rest of the league staff.
Well, Jerome, the big initiative for the South Carolina High School League, and it's really on display here today, and that's sportsmanship.
Absolutely. Sportsmanship is our staple. That's what we actually believe in, and this is one of the sports that we can really show it. This is probably one of our most toughest sports that an athlete can compete in, because it's just, although you're competing as a team, it's just you and the other person, and you've got to put everything on the line. So I think once you leave here, once you come off that mat, you know that you've given all that you can to the people that support you. And I want to thank all the schools, and again, we've noticed this in the communities, the fans supporting athletics here.
Yeah, it's been a great crowd here on hand so far here at Dreher High School. Jerome Singleton, thank you to you, to all of your wonderful staff, to our wonderful member schools, their administrators, all of the athletes, the coaches, the communities, everybody involved with high school athletics, thank you so much.
Please know that we appreciate all that Play On Sports does in helping us with the SCHSL.TV and the work that you do, Bert, because you really helped us to put this thing at another level.
Well, thank you so much, Jerome Singleton, Commissioner of the South Carolina High School League. Thank you again for spending time with us as we are moments away from getting this 2A Duels Wrestling State Championship underway. We've got the introductions taking place now, and we will start with the 138-pound weight class. That will be our first weight class on the mat when we get this match underway between Hanahan and Emerald. Emerald, this is their first ever appearance in the state championship. Let's welcome back Bill Pierce. Bill, Hanahan, they've been here before. The record shows a lot, doesn't it? 20-7.
Yeah, it doesn't. They've had a lot of matches this year, got a lot of good experience that way. But in talking to a friend of mine who's a 2A coach, he's really expecting a lot from Emerald this year in this match. They have a lot of kids that scmat.com's got ranked up in the top, towards the top, and they look like they're ready to go.
Well, we are moments away now as the introductions have been made. Our officials for this 2A state championship, Dino White is our head official and Sean Swoop is the assistant. And again, we're going to be, Matthew Finley is our head official. Jimmy Campbell is his assistant. I got ahead of myself a little bit with the 3A matches, which will be coming up immediately following the Class 2A matches. Congratulations to Bamberg Earhart, winners of the Class A state championship, as we saw here earlier on the SCHSL network broadcast. And we're going to start with the 138-pound weight class. We'll have Chris Jackson for Emerald facing off with, we believe, will be Haven Holback or either George Williams for Hanahan. Emerald, the upper state champions, they are the home team here today. They are in the purple and gold or purple and yellow singlet. Moving to the right of your screen, Hanahan in the blue and orange singlets. To the left of your screen, they're the lower state champs and the visitors, and we are underway, 138-pounders.
And they're getting after it. Hanahan's looking for a cow catcher here, trying to take him straight to his back, muscle him over a little bit. Emerald's doing a really good job of staying square and fighting out of that position.
And, Bill, while we can, we might as well take the opportunity now to explain to our viewers on the SCHSL network broadcast that it's a little bit difficult for the announcers, you and I, as the coaches can make last-minute changes, and we really never know who the wrestler is going to be out on the mat as we see really good action going right now.
Right. The coaches have a lot of tactics they can employ by bumping different wrestlers to match different wrestlers where they think that they can take advantage of a weaker wrestler or negate a stronger wrestler's bonus points. Right there is a good little flurry with Emerald coming out on top and getting the takedown.
Now Emerald with 2 points, Hanahan with four. This is the first of 14 matches for the Class 2A State Championship. Emerald, the wrestler in the purple and yellow, on top of the wrestler from Hanahan in the orange and blue. For Emerald, it is Chris Jackson. He is a junior. And we believe that is Haven Horlback for Hanahan.
Emerald's looking for some back points. He didn't quite get it, couldn't hold him on his back, but he still has that arm trapped in the hammerlock. They're getting close to going out of bounds. We'll restart in the center.
4-2, Hanahan leading with 22 seconds remaining here in the first of three periods.
Yeah, very active match to start out. These guys were obviously fired up and came out here to wrestle.
So Emerald on top.
Hanahan's grabbed Emerald's leg. He's looking to get a scramble position. No change as they go out of bounds. And we need to see the Hanahan wrestler's getting up to his feet, but he's not really getting hand control and any hip separation, which is going to make it hard for him to score. Now he's trying to get some hand control, get his hips out, but Emerald's done a good job and has got him in a Burl Nelson. Got him in a Burl Nelson on his back. Time runs out. Let's see. Yes, he had enough time to get his two near fall points. Good job by Emerald.
Yeah, excellent move there for Emerald, picking up 2 points to tie it here, 4-4, as we move quickly now into the second period.
It looks like Hanahan is deferred choice to Emerald for this period, and Emerald's taken the neutral position. He must feel very confident on his feet.
Emerald wearing the green leg band, Hanahan in the red, so that's how we will tell with the official who is getting the points.
And
if he puts
Emerald,
his green hand up in the air, the official, then that's going to Emerald.
Emerald attempted a headlock hip toss and really didn't get his hips out so that Hanahan was able to roll through and come up with the takedown. Nice job by Hanahan to counter that move.
2 points for Hanahan. Leading here 6-4. Haven Horlback for the Hawks, defending state champs. We're in the second period here, 138-pound weight classification. 145's coming up next. Horlback with his position trying to get the hips.
And he got an escape and immediately went to a front headlock position. It's got a near side cradle hooked up. That's a two-point takedown. He's going to try and pull him back into bounds so he can get his near fall points.
Yeah, that was three quick points right there for Emerald. They lead now 7-6.
Very quick, and that was good by him. Good mat awareness coming up and getting the escape and immediately getting back on the attack to score quick points. And he has now pulled Hanahan back in bounds. If he can keep Hanahan's shoulders in bounds and turn him onto his back, he can get some near fall points here. This near side cradle is a very, very difficult position for a disadvantaged wrestler to get out of.
Chris Jackson for Emerald losing his headgear a little bit here.
He's got to scoot his, he's got to get his shoulders in. His shoulders are still out. Got to pull his shoulders back in, and they go out of bounds.
And a chance for Jackson to adjust the headgear. Jackson leading 7-6 here in the second period with 15 seconds remaining. And Jackson will have the advantage position, which he has had all match.
Yeah, he has definitely been the aggressor, especially on top. He's doing a good job of locking up that cradle.
What would you like to see more of from Haven Hole back here for Hanahan?
You know, he probably needs to stay out of these scramble situations and really get some good fundamentals going. If he could get hand control here, see, he turns into a body lock, and that's just not a very smart move. He's lucky that he didn't go to his back there. He really needs to get some hip separation when he gets to his feet and hand control so he can get away.
And he's saved by the clock there, though. As time expires, we'll move into the third and final period.
And it looks like
very
Hanahan,
even match here so far.
Yeah, it looks like Hanahan had choice, and he chose to be on neutral again, which is probably a wise decision since he hasn't had much luck getting off the bottom. Tries a duck under shot, doesn't get it. Emerald's got that cow catcher position locked back up, tight on the head and under the arm, and he's trying to throw him and drive him to his back. And yes, 2 points, and he's on. Got Hanahan on his back, looking
going for the
fall.
Pin.
There it is.
That
nice
is huge
job
for
by
Emerald.
Very nice pin. Job. And you could tell he was looking for the pin the entire match.
So Emerald comes up with six big points early. Our first match goes to Emerald, and how about that? Chris Jackson, the junior, staking Emerald to the early lead.
I tell you what, he looked impressive in that match. A couple of mistakes early on, but he came back and took control of it.
145-pound classification. Should be Bryce Ellis and Raymond Williams. Raymond Williams for Emerald. Bryce Ellis, the reigning region champion for Hanahan. So Williams to the right of your screen, Bryce Ellis to the left for Hanahan.
There.
All points with the from the official red signifying points going to Hanahan. Green signifies points going to Emerald.
A lot of action here. We haven't really seen a setup for the shot. They're just kind of reaching for the leg right now. They need to get their setups a little bit better. They both seem fairly comfortable reaching, shooting from outside. Oh, Emerald's in on a good single leg, but Hanahan's countering him tough with a whizzer and getting his hips down and back. And comes out to square up. Good job by Hanahan to counter that single leg attempt.
Now, one thing I'm noticing early from Bryce Ellis is he's very quick coming off the knee. Once he puts that knee to the mat, he is able to pop up rather quickly.
He seems very explosive, yeah. But it doesn't seem like he wants to tie up. It seems like Hanahan's trying to get in there close to tie him up and work some shots off tie up, and Emerald seems content to stay at a distance and look for an outside shot.
It appears, Ellis, that his strength is shooting. That he's more the aggressor, more the attacker, likes to drop down and go for the legs and ankles.
He looks like he's probably the quicker wrestler by watching him move a little bit, so he is probably looking for that outside shot. There he goes again for a sweep single. Didn't set it up too well. He's got to get a better setup, get that leg coming to him. He's shooting at a leg that's moving away from him, and it's going to be hard for him to secure that leg doing that.
Williams for Emerald. Right of your screen. Locked up with Bryce Ellis for Hanahan to the left.
Right. He's taking a lot of shots, but he's just not setting them up to where he can penetrate deep enough to get in on that leg. He needs to move Hanahan a little bit in a circle. And Hanahan, on his part, is controlling the tie, but he needs to work something from that tie. He needs to get Emerald off balance and circle a little bit and get his own leg attacks going.
You think Bryce Ellis for Hanahan could have tried to slip a front headlock there?
If he could head snap, yeah. Really good position. And it looks like he could. He's not really trying it too much. Emerald's back in now. He's coming to the waist, and that wizard's going to be pretty tight, but Hanahan tries to throw him, and no points.
So no points scored here in the first period. We'll move to the second period. No score.
It looks like Emerald's deferred choice to Hanahan, and Hanahan's going to choose the bottom position to try and get a point on the board first.
Which position do you prefer, Bill?
Personally, I would rather be in the top position. You take a lot of abuse in the bottom, and if you stop moving, you're in trouble. You've got a lot of motion, and that's what Hanahan's done. He has moved off the whistle. He's moved quick, and he's got the reversal, and he's looking for a fall. Very good job off the bottom.
Ellis looking for the fall here on Williams. If he can get the shoulders flush with the mat, the official right there, he got it. There's a fall for Hanahan. We're even now, six apiece.
Big, big, big pin for Hanahan to get them back tied up in this match. Great job coming off the bottom. Really exploded. Got his reversal right into a near fall situation. And I think we're going to see returning state champ Dennis Flores up here next. This looks like Flores won a state title last year at 145.
Yeah, and he's impressive. I watched him last year in this very same gymnasium. Dennis Flores, 2011 individual state champ, Southeast regional runner-up, high school All-American as a sophomore, region champion 2010, 2011, 2012. What a resume there for the 152-pound Dennis Flores. And he is going to be facing, I believe that's Connor Carowin.
Very impressive resume for Flores, and you know, obviously a lot of experience, a lot of confidence, and he looks like a very powerful wrestler and gets right after it. They go out of bounds without any points scored, but Flores is on the attack moving forward.
Yeah, that's Connor Carowin for Emerald in the purple and yellow. There's Flores moving over. He's in the blue and orange.
Headlock position, trying to secure his points, and gets behind for 2 points. Very nice job.
One thing about Flores, he can finish a match early.
And I think that's probably what Hanahan's going to look for, to get a little bit of a lead here with some bonus points.
If Carowin can take Flores into the second period, he's won a small battle. Under a minute 20 remaining, Flores working on top. He's going after that left wrist there.
He's very active, trying to pull that arm out, put it in a hammerlock position. Now he's going for a cross face. Maybe looking for a cross-face cradle. He's just active on top, which is what you need to do when you're on top. Just keep working to turn the man. That's your obligation as the top wrestlers, to turn the man and look for near fall points or a pin.
Flores has a lot of moves in his toolbox. Very technical wrestler, very fundamentally sound wrestler.
And Emerald has already picked up a stall call for inactivity on the bottom. You can see that the Emerald wrestler is really just trying to hold base and not really trying to work to improve his position.
So Flores leading here 2-0 over Carowin. Connor Carowin, a junior.
False start on the top man, Hanahan. Jumped the whistle just a little bit, and that's going to be a caution.
Next time will be points.
No, next time you get a second caution, and then the third time it would be points. Yeah, they allow you two cautions just in case you're a little quick off the whistle.
Flores gets back position.
And he's got that arm back out, stretching it across
that's
the back.
That's not where Carowin wants it.
No, you don't want to be there, and it looks like he's trying for Haskins. Now he's switched off to a cow catcher, but Emerald, to his credit, is doing a good job of slipping out of these pinning combinations. And he needs to try and get to his feet and get a point here. All he's doing is really hanging on to Flores, trying to keep him from turning them.
I'll tell you what, though, Connor Carowin doing his job so far, only trailing by 2 points, and we're into the second period here.
Right, and I'm sure his coach has told him, you know, to go out there, wrestle tough, and try not to give up the fall. I'm sure that's their, you know, they'd like to win, of course, but I think in this situation with Flores being as accomplished as he is, what they're looking for is to try and limit the damage.
Carowin bottom, Flores top.
Tries to switch off the whistle, didn't get it. Flores has got him back down. He's got to keep working here on the bottom. Got to get those wrists free and try and get hand control and get to his feet or get his hips clear.
Flores very active.
Oh, he's got that leg bowed up, putting a lot of pressure on the bottom man's hip. Coming across to that cross face, trying to take him over.
2-0, Flores leading.
All right, he's
in
broken the 45,
here.
Gotten a count. 2 points. 2 point near fall there for Flores from Hanahan.
So 4-0 now for Flores and the Hanahan Hawks.
He's looking for a tilt here. He needs to elevate the Emerald's bottom leg so he can expose those backs. I don't think he broke the 45 there.
Out of bounds, so back to the center circle.
It looks like Flores wants to start back on his feet.
Neutral position.
So he's just given Emerald a 1 point escape so they can start back neutral.
4-1.
Now he's back in a headlock position, looking to come behind. He's digging that head under the armpit to put pressure up towards the shoulder area and get the man off balance so he can spin behind.
Bill, explain the strategy behind Flores' decision to give up the 1 point to Carowin in favor of going to neutral position.
He probably felt that the Emerald wrestler was doing a good job of keeping him from turning him to his back. So he figured he'd start back on his feet, get another 2 points, and work from there. And a lot of times once you take a guy down, immediately after scoring the takedown, bottom man is often susceptible to getting put on his back if you transition into a pinning hold. And that's what Flores is looking to do. He's now back in a front headlock position. Moving him really well. He's working his short offense.
And Flores showing off his upper body strength right there. But Carowin doing a good job here of preventing Flores from trying to find his position to get a fall. And as the second period comes to a close, we'll move into the third period. And you know Coach Andy Wright for Emerald has to be really happy with his wrestler here who is only trailing by 5 points going into the third period against one of the top wrestlers in South Carolina.
Right, and if he can keep this to a regular decision and only 3 points, that's a win for Emerald. Because I know Hanahan is expecting bonus out of their wrestler, and they're probably hoping for a pin here.
And there's the second foul.
Second caution. Next one would be a point if he jumps the gun again. And he's quickly up to his feet, hand control, hips away, perfect. That was a perfectly executed stand-up and goes for a fireman's dump right to the back. Big move.
Ball.
Big move here.
He's looking for the pin. Got it. There's a middle fall for Hanahan and Flores. And boy, did Connor Carowin fight hard, though, for Emerald.
and very impressive. You know, Flores shot up off the whistle from the bottom, got his hand control, got his hips away to get his escape, but instead of resetting and taking a second and allowing Emerald to get back into a good position, he immediately shot a fireman's carry and dumped him straight to his back. Very good transition from an escape to a takedown to a near fall.
Now we move into the 160-pound classification. Forrest Bowman, left side of your screen for Hanahan. And it looks like Demarcus Turner, yes, the senior for Emerald. Demarcus Turner. Turner, left side of your screen.
Turner on Emerald is ranked 12th on SC Mat, so probably they're looking for a win here. And he's trying this headlock hip toss.
And Forrest Bowman, he's a region champion here in 2012.
It looks like Emerald's really trying to muscle the upper body here, so what Hanahan needs to do is control the tie and get a good leg attack going. Maybe throw Emerald off his game because he's obviously trying for some upper body attacks. Looking to try and maybe throw Hanahan to his back from his feet. And Hanahan doesn't want to be in that position. You don't want to be in that position against an athlete.
Looking for a hip toss there. He takes him down.
Right. Emerald countered really well and got the takedown. And that's why I say when you're wrestling a really athletic guy, you probably don't want to get in those upper body ties like that.
And I need to correct myself. That is Shaq Oliver for Emerald, the sophomore. Shaq Oliver inserted over to Marcus Turner. Oliver can go 152 pounds or 160. So Coach Andy Wright puts Shaq Oliver on the mat as opposed to Marcus Turner.
Emerald's got his, he's working that arm. He's got the arm trapped on the back. He really needs to try and flatten him out. It looks like he's looking for a Haspins, but it's going to be tough to get when the man's on his base. But he's got it locked, but once he, oh.
Nice little
back trip. He's still got the Haspins locked up. This is where he wants to be. He wants to be throwing them, and there he goes. Very effective pinning combination.
Shaq Oliver going for the fall. There it is. That's big for Emerald. Huge.
That is big.
We're tied again, 12-12.
That really just negates the pin that that Flores got for Hanahan.
So Forrest Bowman goes down. Shaq Oliver comes up with the win. A sophomore, region champion as well. And he picks up the fall in the first period. Arsenio Lewis for Emerald. Going against Brett Maddox for Hanahan. Maddox to the left of your screen. Lewis to the right. We're in the 170-pound classification. Brett Maddox was a region champion for Hanahan a year ago. Arsenio Lewis, two-time defending region champion. He is a senior. 25-4 record, not too shabby.
No, not too shabby at all. Emerald took a shot from the outside. Hanahan did a nice job of countering out of it.
170-pound classification. We're tied on the team score here, 12-12. Four matches through, 10 to go. This is match number 5 of 14.
Ooh, nice little out low single from the outside. His head's to the outside now. He needs to come around, and oh, Hanahan's got him extended. Emerald's in a little bit of trouble. He's got back to his base. He's coming out. He needs to try and turn out, but Hanahan's doing an excellent job of countering that shot. And should be get the points here if he can get his head free and get Emerald under control. And there, that's a two-point takedown. Nice job by countering for Hanahan off of a pretty decent little low shot.
That's Maddox in the blue and orange on top.
Ooh, we might have a reversal here. They go out of bounds, and the official's going to signal one-point escape because they went out of bounds before Emerald was able to get the reversal.
Yeah, Lewis thought he had two, didn't he?
If he had had a couple more inches of real estate, he probably would have.
And quickly, Bill, let's go over the scoring if we can for the folks that maybe a little less seasoned in high school wrestling. Reversal, escape.
Okay, when they're on their feet neutral like they are currently, If one man takes the other man to the mat under control, it's a two-point takedown. Right here, he's got a single leg. He takes him to the mat. That's his 2 points for a takedown. The bottom man now, the only way he can score is either to get back to his feet and face the top man, getting a skate, making the match neutral again, or going from the bottom to the top, which would be worth 2 points. A skate worth one, reversal worth two. The top man scores his points by doing exactly what he's doing right here, putting the man on his back. If he holds the man on his back, breaking a 45-degree angle for a two count, he'll get 2 points, as he just did. If he can hold him for a five count, he'll get 3 points.
Excellent job.
Excellent job by Hanahan right there, taking the man to his back and getting those points. Those are big points. He's now 1 point away from bonus.
8-1 is the score. Hanahan leading this match with Brett Maddox. Arsenio Lewis, the wrestler for Emerald. Maddox again in control as we start the second period here.
And when I say bonus, I'm talking about the team score. If you beat your opponent by a 7 point difference, it's just called a decision. That's 3 team points. But if you're able to beat your opponent by 8-14 points, an 8-14 point difference, that's a major decision. That's worth 4 points. As we see, Emerald got a nice reversal there for two. If one man is able to get a 14 point difference at any point during the match will be stopped. He'll be declared the winner by technical fall and he'll get his team 5 points. If he gets the pin, that's worth 16 points, and those are big points.
Yeah, and the pinfalls, that's really when a team can stake itself to a big lead and put the other team in a major disadvantage.
Correct. I mean, if you do out of the 14 weight classes, if you do a little bit of math, if five guys score six pins, they have 30 points, and if the other eight guys or nine guys, you know, just score a regular decision, that's only 27 points. So the team that would win the fewer matches because they won by fall would win the match. It takes two regular decisions to equal one pin, so you don't want to give up pins, but you all want to work very hard to get a pin.
Oh, nice move here by Lewis. Look at how he has that arm, but Maddox able to slip his arm away.
Maddox needs to start being a little more active on the bottom. He's been warned for stalling, for not doing anything. Top man's doing all the work. Now, top man only has 5 seconds to return him to the mat before he gets called for stalling.
Lewis has really closed the gap here in this period.
Very nice. Picked up the leg and came down and reversed the position for a two-point reversal. Nice job by Hanahan there at the end of the period.
10-5 now. Maddox make it. Yes, 10-5 for Maddox and Hanahan, but overall a good second period there for Emerald and Arsenio Lewis, who quietly picked up 4 points.
Right. He did a good job. Hanahan's taking the match to him. He's got that lead, and it's because he's getting these reverses, because Emerald's getting a little sloppy in his technique at times and giving him opportunities to get reversals and get near-fall points.
Emerald High School, the Vikings out of Greenwood, South Carolina. Hanahan, the Hawks.
Hanahan needs to get his head clear here so he can score his takedown points. Emerald's just trying to hold on. He needs to work his legs back and improve his position, or he will give up a takedown. If Emerald will just kind of walk him to his back, you know, he should get his takedown points. But both men are kind of look a little tired right now. There we go. He's got his head clear and gets his 2 point takedown.
Makes it 12-5 now for Maddox and Hanahan with a minute 15 remaining here in the third and final period.
And I think this potentially dangerous, and as we talk. Oh, illegal move. He took the arm too far up the back, so that's 1 point for Emerald on an illegal move.
Not a deduction, but a point for Emerald.
Got to be careful, as we talked before about trying to prevent injury. You cannot take an arm that's behind the back past the 90 degrees, because you don't want to put undue pressure on the joints.
Yeah, that's really when you can start to develop some orthopedic problems, and that's the reasoning for that.
Exactly. And you don't want to see any wrestler have his season ended with an injury like that.
Lewis trying to slip the ankle hold.
I think both wrestlers have expended a tremendous amount of energy in this match. It's been up tempo up to the third period, and now they're kind of slowing down a little bit.
You see there's
no explosion off the bottom and not much explosion on top.
The heavy breathing has increased.
Right,
this has been a big cardio workout for both wrestlers.
But you know, Emerald really needs to get moving. He's down by 6 points here, and he's not doing a whole lot. And Hanahan's really working him pretty tough, but if he would just get to his base, and once again, Emerald gets called for stalling. He's not really trying to improve down there, and he needs to. He's down by 6 here. He needs to score some points.
Maddox trying to roll Lewis over, going for a pinfall, but it looks like Lewis.
He's getting his count. He secured his 3-point near fall at the buzzer and extends his lead 15-6, so that's a major decision.
Yeah, 1-9, major decision
for Hanahan. Nice job. 4 points, major.
Four points, yep. So Hanahan wins that one, and they pick up 4 points. Actually, scoreboard showing 3, showing 15-12. As the overall team score, we thought it would be 16.
Well, if it was a 15-6 match, that's a 9-point swing, so that should have been a major decision for 4 points. Let's see if they change it or if there's a mistake in the individual map score.
Now they've brought the scoreboard down to 14. So only 2 points awarded for that decision.
Well,
now
they're going to change 16. That. Yeah, there isn't a 2-point decision.
Now we're right.
There we go. So they got that cleared up. And those points are, you know, very important. I'm liking the pink sock look here. It's very nice.
Emerald, right side of your screen, Hanahan left. Hanahan, 180-pounder, is Equan Brown. And for Emerald, Anthony Kelly. Kelly, a senior with a 23-5 record.
Yeah, they have a tight collar tie there. One man's going to need to get his head free a little bit to give him some room to shoot. You really can't shoot when you're tied up that tight in a collar tie.
Emerald left of your screen, Hanahan right. That's Brown for Hanahan and Kelly for Emerald.
These wrestlers just seem to be feeling each other out, not really committing to anything right now. Need to get a little bit more motion, some circular motion, lateral motion to get a leg coming to you. And it looks like they're going to try and go upper body. Hanahan didn't want to be in that position, so he got out.
Went right back to the center circle. You're right, Bill. Both wrestlers just kind of feeling each other out right here, just kind of pecking on one another.
Right. Neither one's really committing to any kind of leg attack. It kind of looks to me like Emerald's looking for an upper body lock of some sort, maybe.
Under 30 seconds remaining here in the first period. No score. Kind of a slow pace right now.
Right. Nice little double leg shot. He's powered up. He's got his body lock. Somebody could be going to their back from this position.
Either wrestler, really, and it's going to be Hanahan.
He gets his takedown and puts him straight to his back, so he's getting near fall points. That's why those body locks are very dangerous to be in if you're not comfortable there.
Yeah, 2 points for Quan Brown and Hanahan.
And three
his
more time
expires, yep. So 5 points total in that period for Hanahan and Quan Brown.
Looks like Hanahan's going to choose the bottom. Oh, he...
Yeah, he is going around choosing the bottom.
And he's got a hole here to... Or actually, he's in the lead at 5. He's going to try and extend that lead, get an escape or reversal here. He needs to explode off the whistle. He needs to take advantage of his athleticism and get back up to his feet. But Emerald did a good job of stopping that by securing the ankle. And the tight waist ankle and trying to flatten him out. Emerald could only hold that ankle for 5 seconds, and he lets go. Got him flat. Little really needs to work here for a turn. He's in a five-point hole. He needs to put the Hanahan wrestler on his back and make some points back up.
Yeah, Brown doing a good job of kind of keeping his base, even though he's on his stomach, making it very difficult for Kelly to roll him over.
Right, he doesn't want to stay on his stomach because he'll get called for stalling if he just lays there. And it's also a lot easier to put someone on their back when they're flat on their stomach, as opposed to if he gets back to his hands and knees or his base position. That gives him options to stand up or sit out and get his hips away and work for an escape or a reversal. Right now, there's not a whole lot he can do laying there, so he needs to start working himself back up. And Emerald needs to start working a pinning combination. He can't lay there parallel. If he just lays on the man parallel, he's going to get called for stalling himself. Let's see what's called.
That's a point for Hanahan.
He called an illegal move on Emerald. I didn't really see. He might have touched his hands in a full Nelson position. I'm not sure.
He did.
And that's 1 point. You can't put a full Nelson in. That could severely injure a wrestler's neck.
6-0 for Hanahan and Quan Brown. Anthony Kelly struggling to pick up some points here for his Emerald Vikings as they trail by 4 in the overall, 16-12. Kelly's going to have to be careful here with his hands on the neck of Brown.
Now he's doing it right this time. He's got the half Nelson in, and he's secured the far wrist to keep himself from putting his hands together in a full Nelson. And now he's got an arm bar. See if he can work this. But Hanahan's doing a good job. He's gotten back to his base to fight that. And now he needs to score some points. He needs to try and stand up here. He really needs to stand up here.
Brown able to move out of bounds, so we'll go back to the center circle. There was a window of opportunity there, I thought, for Anthony Kelly, but Brown just closed it really quickly.
You know, if Hanahan continues to just kind of lay around on the bottom, he's giving Emerald the opportunity to get some to turn to his back. He really needs to work up. He's trying to stand up here. Emerald does a good job of securing his ankles and bringing him flat, but he can't lay there.
He's got a half Nelson in.
Oh, that's full Nelson again.
Yep. He had it locked with his left hand, but then brought the right over.
It's only either touch, just your fingertips touching together, or them just both fingertips just touching on the back of the neck constitutes a full Nelson, even if it's just
even
for
if
a
it's
second.
No pressure. Yeah.
So he can't do that. He's giving away. He's giving away points that they can't afford to give away.
7-0 here for Hanahan and Brown, and that's going to do it for the second period.
That's Emerald's choice, and we'll see where Emerald's going to choose the bottom. And he needs to get working here. He's got to get some points on the board.
So Kelly chooses bottom. And Hanahan's Quan Brown looks a little winded to me.
I think so, yeah. I think he is winded. You know, just laid there on the bottom. Showing a lot of good power there, returning him to the mat.
Forces Kelly down. He's trying to roll him over.
He's got that far arm trapped, and he's trying to pick up the leg. He probably needs to pick up the leg there at the knee and try and turk. Emerald's doing a good job of shifting his weight away. He needs to free up that wrist. Maybe come from below it and roll it out, and there he's got it free. He's got hand control. Now he needs to try and stand up or sit out, do something to put himself in a position to score.
He's got that left ankle with Kelly. That's a point for Emerald. Did he hold that ankle too long, Bill?
I think possibly, yeah. I'm not sure what the call was. It might have been another stalling call. It might have been the second stall call for holding that too long.
He can only hold that ankle for 5 seconds.
Yeah, give or take, depending on the official, but they don't want you just to ride it. Oh, and nice explosive move off the bottom to just run behind the back and get his two reversal.
But Kelly was close to going to the full Nelson again there. Bill.
Yeah, something happened, and the official called a potentially dangerous situation, which means no points are awarded, but they stopped the action so that the wrestler doesn't get injured. Once again, this is a very tough and brutal sport. You want to put your opponent in some discomfort to break him physically and mentally and get him to go to his back, but you don't want to permanently injure him or damage any part of his body.
Yeah, major kudos and credit to the officials for being on top of that and ensuring the safety of these competitors. Minute 5 remaining here in the third period. Hanahan leading 7-3. Kelly for Emerald trying to find some points here in the closing seconds.
Yeah, he gets that half in, but he really doesn't come out to the side where he can put pressure and drive into him. He's staying behind Hanahan's hips, and you're not going to turn a guy doing that. You need to come out to the side, get perpendicular, and drive into him. But once again, there's another stall call on Hanahan, so that's a point for Emerald.
7-4 now, 35 seconds remaining. Can Kelly mount a comeback, or will Brown be able to just fend off the surge from Emerald's Kelly?
You know, Hanahan, oh, he's got him. He's got that half in tight. If he'll come out to the side and drive, but Hanahan shifts his weight and fights out of it.
Well, they have time, 7 seconds. Brown will survive.
Another stall call. That's 2 points. One more. If there had been more time and there had been another stall, he would have been disqualified. So, you know, Hanahan picked up a one-point decision, but if he hadn't laid around and stalled so much during the match, he was in a position to get his team some bonus points, which I'm sure they could have used. Looks like we have a discussion. Maybe they don't agree on the points.
Keeping both wrestlers on the mat.
Right, I think the points are correct. Yep. And Hanahan's going to get the win, but once again, he was in a position to pick up some bonus points for his team and didn't do it. And we'll see if that comes back and kind of haunts them later.
Yeah, 3-point decision there, Bill.
Right. If you can get bonus points in these dual competitions, you want to. You want to get that point difference because every little point makes a difference. And I think we'll see that in some of the matches later today where bonus points won't come probably as often. But when they come, they're really important.
195-pound weight class. Lyndon Young, the 2012 region champion for Hanahan, going against Trey Brown for Emerald.
A little head snap there. Gets into a single, gets out of it.
And both of these athletes showing a lot of agility for 195-pound weight class. Very quick.
Emerald seems like they're pretty confident in these body lock positions. They like to get an over-under lock. And he didn't score there, but made Hanahan have to wiggle on out of it.
19-12 score. No score here in this match. 195-pound weight class. Lyndon Young for Hanahan, right side of your screen. Locked in with Trey Brown.
Another body lock and takes him right down to his back. Gets a 2-point takedown. He hasn't been able to put him on, get his shoulders in bounds, break that 45 to get his back points.
Nice bridge by Lyndon Young to avert.
Right, and because his shoulders are out of bounds, there's no possibility of giving up points or getting a pin there. They should be starting. Hanahan should be down.
2 points for Emerald and Trey Brown.
Once again, Emerald seems very comfortable in those body lock positions and have scored several times in these past couple matches from there. There's a false start caution on Hanahan, the first caution. Once again, he's given two cautions without being penalized.
Under a minute.
Now that'll be a caution on false start on the top man lined up a little incorrectly there. A little mental error.
And that's Trey Brown for Emerald.
Yeah, top man has got to have a hand on the belly button and a hand on the elbow.
Brown working on Lyndon Young, has the ankle. Young spins out to the white line. Now trying to turn away from Trey Brown.
Emerald did a good job of kind of corralling him back towards the center of the mat where he can actually work on it, because it doesn't do you a whole lot of good to turn a man if he's going to be out of bounds. You're not going to get any points. So you want him towards the center.
And Lyndon Young just trying to swim away here, trying to get back to his base.
He's having a lot of difficulty getting out from under. He's got hand control now to the hip. There you go. That was a proper stand-up technique, and now he's in on a double. Runs out of time. But he got the escape that time because he got hand control and got it down off his hip and got his hips away to turn.
So he picks up the point, Lyndon Young does, right at the buzzer.
And that was a big escape point. Yeah. He did not want to leave that period without having scored that point.
Hey, you never want to leave points on the table.
No, you do not. And if you can score right at the end of the period, all the better. Doesn't give the other man a chance to answer.
2A Duels Wrestling State Championship here on the SCHSL Network. Hanahan and Emerald. Hanahan leading 19-12. Emerald leading this match 2-1.
Double leg shot. He's powering through him. Drive double. Oh, no points. Emerald did a good job of avoiding it.
Very impressed with Trey Brown for Emerald.
Yeah, he's done a good job of fighting off those positions that, you know, Hanahan should have scored there. And he scrambled. He didn't ever quit. He didn't just give up the takedown. He kept moving and kept working.
Double wrist lock. Now to the back of the net for Lyndon Young. Just trying to find some position.
Hanahan in on a body lock now. And Emerald going double overhooks. Trying to trip. He's trying to trip. And they'll go out of bounds without scoring.
Now look at the determination in the face of Trey Brown for Emerald.
Right, but Hanahan is really making him expend a lot of energy. And, you know, we've got a minute left in this period and then another two-minute period, so we'll see how his gas tank is. Because Hanahan's making him work, and there's the first stalling call. Emerald was backing up and is not working to attack, so it's been called for stalling.
That's our first stalling call of this match. Brown looking for a way in here on Lyndon Young, and Young has done a good job of just spreading those legs wide, controlling his hips. Just makes it really difficult for Brown to establish himself.
Yeah, he's fighting position really well and making it difficult, but somebody needs to get in on the legs and get a takedown here, and Emerald really hasn't taken a leg shot this match. He needs to try and set. He's got elbow control there, and he's got head position. He needs to try and work something. Hanahan, nice little high crotch shot. Will they reward it? No. They said the buzzer went out before he had control.
Well, Bill, our first four matches all ended in six-point pinfalls.
Right.
Since then, the last two have been decisions.
Right.
And this one kind of shaping up the same way.
It's really like a new match. You know, it's, you know, without giving up the pin, they're just going for decisions. And Hanahan really needs to get some points here and extend their lead a little bit. But Emerald, you know, needs to get a takedown and look for a fall because they're down by 7 right now in the team score. They need to close that gap a little bit. Right now they're only looking at a 3-point decision. Well, Hanahan has really been more of the aggressor on his feet with the leg attacks, and I think that's showing in Emerald. But he's got good position here if he can get his hips back and
looking for a trip.
Right. Brown. It's behind him now. He needs to lift him and take him to the mat. Get his takedown. No, going out of bounds. They'll go out of bounds. Emerald's expending a lot of energy and doing a lot of work, but not getting points. And that's Hanahan's doing a good job of countering, but Emerald's not helping themselves by changing his locks and not sticking with the move he's in.
Coming in on under a minute remaining in this third and final period here. Emerald leading by only
nice
1 point, 2-1.
Double leg. And Hanahan keeps coming up too high on the hips, I think, when he's in on that double. He gets good position on that double and starts to drive through, but his hands come up too high, allowing Emerald to get his hips back. instead of staying lower on the leg and maybe securing that takedown. And Hanahan needs to score here. He's down by one with 30 seconds left. He needs a takedown to try and win this match.
Hanahan bench yelling, shoot, shoot. They want.
And there's the tying point.
To
Hanahan just
go low.
Emerald just got called for stalling. Hanahan just got a point, so the match is now tied. Both wrestlers, I think, might be happy just going to overtime. They both look a little tired.
Especially Brown. And he is just leaning in.
And we're going to have our first overtime match of the day. Quickly, the overtime rules. There will be a one-minute period to start where they're both on their feet. It's a sudden victory period. So the first person that scores a point, whether it be a takedown or a penalty point of any kind, which is a possibility with the stall calls, will win the match. If it's still tied after this period, they'll flip a coin, and one guy will have a choice of top or bottom to work for an escape or reversal for the bottom man. Then they'll go and do a third period where the other man will have choice of where he wants to be. And if it's still tied, they'll go to a fourth sudden victory period on the mat where the first person that scored in the regulation time will have choice. So right now, whoever scores the first point is going to win. Sudden victory.
And you cannot get called for stalling.
You can get called for stalling. And if Emerald stalls in this match, he'll lose it because he's already given up a stall point, and that would be his third stall call. Nice head snap. He's behind, and there's the 2 points. Nice job by Hanahan.
So Hanahan gets it in overtime, a three-point decision points-wise, and they lead now by 10, 22-12.
And that was a big match for them to give them a little bit of a cushion.
So Hanahan on a three-match win streak right now as Lyndon Young overcomes Trey Brown. Now we move to the 220-pound weight classification. Jacob Garibay for Hanahan. And Jacob Blocker for Emerald. Jacob Blocker is a junior. Also plays football for the Emerald Vikings. Jacob Garibay for Hanahan, left side of your screen. He's the 2012 region champion in this classification.
And he's the higher-ranked wrestler in SC Matt, being ranked 7th in the 1A-2A combined rankings. So I'm sure Hanahan's looking for a victory here and possibly bonus if possible.
You've got to think they want to fall here.
I would think so. They want to extend this lead. I think Emerald's lower weights are pretty strong, so they want to make sure that they get a big lead going into those lower weight classes. But Emerald's doing a good job of pummeling inside and getting those underhooks. But Hanahan's got his head position, and it's keeping him from being able to lock a body lock. And did a good job of getting out of that position. He's got his wrist lock, got his inside control. Good hand fighting.
You've got to think that Emerald possibly feels like they left some points on the mat that last match.
I think they did, yes. They were in control for the entire match, and the stall calls came back to haunt them.
So Jacob Blocker, right side of your screen in the purple and yellow. No score here in this match. Blocker and Jacob Garibay for Hanahan.
A lot of times with these upper weight guys, they don't like to attack the legs too much because they don't like to get below the weight. And bigger guys are usually not as quick as the smaller guys. So we haven't seen a leg attack yet, and they don't really look to be setting one up. So I'm looking for either some kind of body lock, maybe a head snap by one of these guys to try and get the guy off balance to score his points.
Possibly a ankle move or a trip.
I'll tell you, Bamberg in the last match had some very good pass-bys from the collar tie position, and both these teams could probably use that technique, especially in this situation where they're just tying up on the head and pushing and shoving. A pass-by would be a good move to use here.
And the first period comes to a close with no score. Neither wrestler able to find an opening in the other's defense.
And Emerald's gotten choice here and has chosen not to defer, but to actually choose the bottom. And that's a smart move. If you go into the second period with no points on the board, you want to be able to score first just in case it goes to that fourth overtime period so that you have the choice. He's standing up. He's trying to get his hand to him. Guy's hips away. He's turned to face. That should be one escape. Good job by Emerald. Now he's got to be careful. Hanahan's in an over-under position, and he works out of it, and he's looking for his own underhook position.
And Jacob Garibe gets in. Now slips that right arm over Jacob Blocker.
He tried a pass by there and didn't quite get it.
Under a minute and a half remaining now here in the second period, 220-pound classification. It's a 1-0 Emerald.
Emerald's got to be careful. He needs to circle, and he doesn't want to back out of bounds. That's when you get those stall calls. And he did a good job, and they're working towards the center. But somebody here needs to set something up and maybe get some kind of leg attack going. All they're really doing is tying each other up and pushing and shoving.
Garibe trying to go a little low there, but really just kind of pulled in by Blocker. And they move out of bounds.
Yeah, Hanahan had was in a position to really lock up a headlock, and they could have tried to score there, but Emerald did a good job of circling out of that.
There's a big upper body fight going on right now.
And there's a stall call. Emerald has been backing up a good part of the match, and the official doesn't think he's really working to score, so he called him for stalling. Ooh, body lock position. Emerald's looking for a trip. Oh, he's going to try and throw. Very dangerous. He did not get it. That's going to give Hanahan not just the takedown, but some near fall points.
Yeah, Garibay with a chance here, trying to
possibly
hit Blocker on his back.
There it is.
It's a fall. That is huge for the heavyweight Garibay and Hanahan. They pick up 6 points. They are on a 5-match win streak now.
That was big. He went from a match that was very even to a pin. That was big points for Hanahan. Good job. Oh, I think we've got a treat coming up now. A very, very, very impressive freshman heavyweight for Emerald.
And that is Gage Cervenka, just a freshman, ninth grader, coming down to the bottom of your screen now, working his way to the middle right. He's facing off against Joe McGrain. This is the 285-pound classification. McGrain in the blue and orange. Cervenka, the freshman. Bill, you've been impressed with this young man, haven't you?
When we talk about a resume, if you look at what he's accomplished already just as a ninth grader, wrestling in middle school and when he was younger, he's already put up some impressive accomplishments. So looking for some, for him to win this match. But right now, Hanahan's being the more aggressor and is kind of shoving him around.
McGrain for Hanahan might have a little bit of a size advantage on Cervenka. Cervenka pops up off the mat. No score.
Yeah, with that size advantage, Cervenka's probably going to have to look to attack and quickly get an angle
just
to
like
get
that
out from under the weight. Just like that. He gets his angle where the weight's no longer a problem. Gets behind him for two. Very nice takedown by the heavy. And that's impressive because oftentimes you do not see heavyweights taking leg attack shots.
Yeah, that's good technical skills for a freshman.
Especially for a freshman. But if you look at his resume, he's been wrestling for a number of years. Dixie National champ. He's two-time middle school state champ.
Cervenka with a chance here. Cervenka leading 2-0 and looking for more.
Wow.
This is a freshman?
Freshman, yeah. Impressive, but a freshman that's been wrestling for a number of years already, and that's the difference.
Joe McGrain, a senior, and he's a very seasoned wrestler himself, and he is getting all he can bargain for from the ninth grader, Cervenka. Cervenka doing a great job of circling over, maintaining his position, now trying to get McGrain
onto the mat with 10 seconds left. Going for the fall. He got it. Didn't he? No.
Very nice job by the freshman. Lived up to the hype.
How about that?
Very impressive.
Cervenka with the pinfall. 6 points that Emerald
desperately needed. Desperately needed.
From a freshman in the 285-pound weight class. You think we're going to see a lot of this young man?
I think so. I think he's got four state titles on his mind for the future, and watching him over at his bench, he's getting his teammates fired up.
I'm circling this match right here, Gage Cervenka, because this could be the turning point of this match for Emerald if they can get their lightweights to string together some points here.
Right, he got them back to within 10 points of Hanahan, and if they can get a couple of wins here in the lighter weight classes, they'll be in good shape. Nice shot by Hanahan, in on the leg, but Hanahan's doing a good job of countering and gets behind him for the two-point takedown.
106-pound weight classification right here. Kevin Murray, a region champion for Hanahan. He is on top. Jacob Schultz, another freshman for Emerald. 2 points for Hanahan. So Hanahan leads in this match 2-0. They lead in the overall by 10, 28-18.
Hard crossface trying to drive him over. Probably needs to pick up that Turk that leg if he can. Needs to get his leg through and Turk it, get his back points.
Hanahan wrestler, Kevin Murray on top. Working against Jacob Schultz, freshman for Emerald. Kevin circles over, mounts the back, trying to pull that wrist in.
Yeah, once again, Emerald needs to get hand control and try and get some points, but he needs to be careful. There's the count. He's got the 45 broken. He's got his three-point near fall. Now he's looking for a pin. This could be big for Hanahan if they secure this fall.
Murray going for the pin. Really doing a good job of trying to distribute his body weight evenly over his opponent, Jacob Schultz. Arching up.
He needs to put his hips down like that and arch up, picking that head up. He's got not a lot of time. Emerald could still fight here. He's only got
5 seconds.
Good fight by Emerald to avoid giving up the fall at the end of the period.
Yeah, Schultz was in a pickle, but saved by the buzzer, and he did a good job of using his hips and head to arch out of that position.
Well, coach has a problem with the call. He's calling the official over to... Don't know what the problem was there, but seemed to have solved it. Emerald's deferring choice to Hanahan. Hanahan's going to go neutral.
5-0 is your score. Kevin Murray on top as we enter the second period. Our officials for this match, Matthew Finley and Jimmy Campbell.
Quick shot off the whistle. Pays off for Hanahan with a two-point takedown.
So 7-0 now for Hanahan as we...
Emerald needs to break that lock and get his hips away. Nice job to get an escape, get some points on the board. Now Emerald really needs to figure out a way to get the takedown here. He needs to get some points and put himself in a position to get back.
Murray shoots in low.
Very nice double. Caught Emerald walking in without protecting his legs. He needs to circle Emerald in here, and he's going to pull him back in towards the center so he can try and work a pinning combination.
Murray, very, very strong at 106 pounds.
Yeah, he looks like he has a little bit of a size advantage on Emerald. Looks a little more developed upper body, a little taller, big legs.
And Kevin Murray, fundamentally sound as well. And Schultz is just really struggling right now, trailing 9-1.
Yeah, bottom man's really getting worked. Hanahan is just controlling the top position and really keeping the pressure on him. He's going to need to start working to his base. This official will call stalling. We've seen that several matches already.
And Schultz is struggling right now.
Oh, arm bar. Arm bar in the far wrist. He's going to try and walk over the head to turn him. There he goes. He's got him down. He's looking for the pin here. It's going to be a fall. Nice job.
So another 6 points for Hanahan.
And those pins have really opened up the lead for Hanahan. It's going to be very difficult for Emerald to come back. They're going to have to start rattling off some pins themselves. And Hanahan still got their defending state champ coming up. Or I'm sorry, their defending two-time finalist, who will be coming up, I think, next match.
Move into the 113-pound weight class. Avery Reeves will be wrestling for Emerald. As you see, the Hanahan fans celebrating, leading 34-18. Elijah Wortham for Hanahan. Wortham, now right side of your screen, facing Avery Reeves. Reeves is a senior. He's got a very impressive resume as well.
This is a big match for Emerald. They need to get a win here to stay in this competition. And nice shot by Emerald. Nice high crotch. Oh, and he's looking to put him on his back. He needs to walk towards that head. Hanahan did a good job of bailing out and getting to his stomach, preventing the back points.
If my math is correct, Bill, Emerald is going to need at least 3 pinfalls.
You know, that's a lot to ask, but that said, we've seen a great many pins in this match already, so it's not beyond the realm of possibility, but it will be difficult. And Hanahan has a very, very talented wrestler coming up in the next weight class.
3 matches remaining after this one, so with 4 matches, Emerald's
pretty much got to run the table with pins.
They're going to need at least 3 and then pick up a decision.
Right. Nice little throw by there to get his takedown. Let's see what he can do on top. He's very long, so I'd look for him to be working maybe a blanket ride cradle or a pinning combination that's going to employ that length that he has at advantage. False start on Hanahan. He flinched just a little bit.
Emerald started out this championship scoring first on a pinfall by Chris Jackson in the 138-pound classification. Then Hanahan won the next 2 matches by pinfall. Then Emerald in the 160-pound classification, another pinfall. But then Hanahan went on a 5-match win streak.
Oh, he's got the cradle locked up. Let's see if, oh, lock's broke now. Trying to roll through. He's got his leg in. He's scooping the face, but no back points. He didn't hold him for a 2 count, so no points.
I've got to go back to that overtime match. I think that is really when the tide turned for Hanahan. Emerald left those points on the mat.
Right.
Hanahan capitalized. But then Emerald, with their fabulous freshman, Gage Cervenka, giving them a 6-point pinfall in the 285-pound classification, but then Kevin Murray for Hanahan answers the bell. And now Hanahan with a 16-point lead.
I think your point on with saying that overtime victory was by Hanahan, they really pulled out of the air, was a big turning point. Emerald had that match won and installed themselves into overtime and then gave up the takedown. So that was a big match for Hanahan.
Emerald, left side of your screen.
Nice ankle.
Avery Reeves.
Ankle pick attempt, and he gets the takedown.
Yeah, takedown for Elijah Wortham.
So nice job. He's back in this match.
4-3, Emerald lead.
Got to get his hips up here. Oh. Yeah, come on out. He still has control. He's still in control. Looking for a cow catcher. Oh, he's going for cement, and he didn't get it and puts himself on his back. Nice job by countering that by Emerald.
Yeah, he rolled the dice, gambled on that move,
yeah,
and didn't pay off.
And that wasn't a smart gamble. When your team's ahead by that much and you're in the second period, he didn't need to make that gamble. Now he's in a bad spot.
Yeah, because if you're Hanahan here, you're really not looking for a pinfall. You're looking for a decision.
Right. You're looking not to give up a pin. You don't want to let Emerald back in the match.
And that, Emerald, they don't need a pinfall per se right now in this match. They could get by with a decision.
Now, Emerald's got their work cut out for them. I believe the Hanahan wrestlers, J.J. Johnson, who's been a two-time state runner-up the past two seasons. So he's obviously
a
very
talented. A 6-point.
That was a six-point pin.
And that's big for Emerald. That's
that
huge.
That lets Emerald right back in the
They've
match.
They still got the dog in the hunt.
That. But Hanahan's going to look to try and close this out right now.
With J.J. Johnson?
Right. This is one of their big guns. They're counting on him to not just get the win, but probably put some extra points on the board. And
J.J. Johnson, quite a resume. Region champion 2010, 2011, 2012. Southeast regional champ, high school sophomore, All-American, wrestling All-American.
Very impressive, and you just saw what he's capable of. He took a very nice low single shot, didn't quite get it, but immediately transitioned to a double leg to get the takedown.
That was a look at Andy Wright, the head coach for Emerald. His squad's still in it, but they face a tough test going up against J.J. Johnson right now. And Johnson looking for the pinfall here.
And this will close the door.
Can Johnson get him down?
With a minute 30
there
left.
There it is. That's it. Hanahan will repeat the state champions.
Nice job by Hanahan.
Just when Durham Atkins needed some big points, he had his big gun, J.J. Johnson, on the mat. Sometimes that's just how it works out.
Yeah, and that's rough for Emerald, but.
So back to a 16-point advantage with two matches remaining, and mathematically,
and this is obviously
Emerald is eliminated.
This is obviously kind of a pride match, but if this is a Cody Perkle of Emerald and Kyle Sargent of Hanahan, this should be a really competitive match. These guys are pretty evenly matched up in the rankings. Cody Perkle is ranked second at his weight by SC Matt, with Kyle Sargent ranked sixth at the weight. And they're both, this is looking like it's going to be a very exciting match. They're both very active, trying different things. Emerald in on that outside single and gets the takeout. Very nice.
Perkle in the blue and yellow for Emerald. Kyle Sargent in the blue and orange for Hanahan. Hanahan will repeat as state champions as they lead it 40-24 with only one match remaining after this one.
And looking here, Cody Perkle is only a sophomore. He's 31-3 this year, but he was a 2011 national champ at the Dixie Nationals, and that's pretty impressive.
Yeah, you know, Andy Wright has a good foundation to continue to build upon with some talented sophomores and freshmen. Jacob Schultz, a freshman who fought hard. Gage Cervenka, the big man, just a freshman. And now we're seeing Cody Perkle, a sophomore.
He's got that cradle locked up, and that's tight. It's going to be tough to stay off his back, but he's got to fight it for 19 seconds.
And Perkle in excellent position right here as he is pulling Sargent. And that's going to be a tough
6 seconds left
to escape.
Nice job to close out. I mean, I think we got one match coming, but nice job by Emerald.
So back to back. It was not back to back pinfalls for Emerald. They take two out of the last three.
And once again, to touch on what we talked about earlier, it's nice to see that even though Hanahan really has the match sewn up, they're continuing to send a wrestler out there to wrestle instead of just forfeiting to the end.
Yeah, like we said before, it's good for the kids, it's good for the wrestlers, it's good for the fans.
Right.
It's good sportsmanship. It helps build character. And
And, you know, these, and I understand that maybe they might not, coaches that do that might not want their kid to get injured this close to the individual tournament, but these being in this kind of match and this kind of pressure is only going to help them when they get to the state individual tournament. Wrestling in front of a crowd, wrestling in an important duel, and having a tough match.
So this is Brian Joseph. And George Kerhulis.
And Kerhulis seems to be the higher-ranked wrestler here. He's SC Matt's got him at 9 for his weight class, and he seemed to be the more aggressive thus far in the match, getting the takedown and now having a cradle locked up. Hanahan did a good job, and now he gets his hips away. Good, nice escape by Hanahan. Fought out of a cradle and then got immediately to his feet to get his point. Does a little neck wrench whip over. No point scored yet. Whoever gets their hips up higher is going to be able to score here.
It looks like it might be Kerhulis for Emerald.
He did a nice job of not going to his back there. Very difficult position to get out of, and he did a good job countering. He's got a half in, I believe. Trying to pull him across his knee.
Come on, y'all. So Kerhulis trying to pick up some late points for Emerald. Whatever he does, it will not be enough. Hanahan has captured the state championship. They did that with J.J. Johnson on the mat. Two matches ago.
Nice. Suicide cradle. Got him on his back. Oh, time ran out. He should get 2 points here. 3 points. He got the full five count. Nice job.
So Kerhulis leads 4-1 now as we move into the second period.
And he's deferring to Hanahan. Hanahan's going to choose down, which I think is a smart move. He got an escape fairly easy last time. See if he can do it again.
Kerhulis.
Good build on
advantage position.
Very good build on Kerhulis. You can see his shoulders are pretty broad. Yeah. And in wrestling, you want a lot of back strength. That's a lot of your strength, your hips and your back. Got his arm bar in. I'm stretching that arm into a hammerlock. Probably going to look for a Hassman's here. Yep, he's going to look for a Hassman's.
Not there. Continues on that. And that arm bar, though.
Right. If he's going to lace the arm under, he needs to get up higher above the elbow. Okay, now he's got it. Got the forearm trapped.
There it is.
Oh, he's got to watch his balance.
Yep, that was it.
Hanahan did a good job of adjusting his weight, but Kerhulis, in turn, readjusted his weight very nicely.
9-1 for Kerhulis now. Coming close on a minute left here in the second period. Ankle lock. If he could just swing that right leg over and then lock himself in, it's going to be tough for Brian Joseph to escape.
Yeah, he's riding legs tough and putting a lot of pressure on the lower back and hips of the hand-to-hand wrestler while he's working the head.
Cody Perkle, for a sophomore, outstanding wrestler.
Yeah, he got right after it, didn't he? It'll be fun to watch him in 2 weeks at the state tournament. As a number of these guys, we've seen a lot of really good individual wrestlers in these first two matches today.
15 seconds remaining here in the second. Brian Joseph trying to carry this one into the third and final period for Hanahan. His team has already wrapped up the state championship, however. And he survives to the third and final period.
And I like how Kerhulis,
the trailing of 12-1.
I like how Kerhulis kept working there. You know, time was almost up, and he kept working it and ended up getting near fall points because he kept active instead of just trying to ride out the period.
So the final 2 minutes of this Class 2A Duels Wrestling State Championship, Hanahan will win.
Caution, false start. on top man. Oh, this double
almost
caution.
Again, yep. Third time is a point. Got to have that hand on the elbow.
Hand on the elbow and on the belly button. And you'll see a lot of guys cheat on the belly button, kind of putting in a tight waist off the whistle. Sometimes the officials catch it, sometimes they don't. Nice job by Krahulis getting the reversal there.
I tell you, our officials have done an outstanding job in this championship. There's a reason why they are here.
Yes, they've got chosen. There are better officials in the state.
Minute and a half remaining. Last match of the 2A state championship. Emerald, the upper state champion. Hanahan, the lower state champion, soon to be 2012 state champion.
He's trying to get a cradle locked up. Hanahan did a good job of fighting it off.
Krahulis. Technical savvy wrestler just for a 10th grader. Been very impressed with him for the Emerald Vikings. Andy Wright has a lot coming back next year for Emerald.
He does, but as you pointed out last match, Bamberg and Abbeville are both moving up in classification. So
2A wrestling in South Carolina next year is going to be very competitive.
Might be fierce.
We've got Hanahan, Emerald.
Right.
Bamberg, Earhart, Abbeville moving up. Wow.
Yeah. And Abbeville was a very young team as well. Mm-hmm. So
Krahulis switches over. He's got that right arm bar. Now works his way. Flips his position with 10 seconds left, leading 14-1. This is going to be a big decision for Emerald, but too little too late.
Yeah.
As the fans from Hanahan count it down. George Krahulis gave it all he could as he wins 14-1, but the champions for 2012 Class 2A, Hanahan repeats, the Hawks win it again as they knock off Emerald 40-34 in what was a very, very entertaining Class 2A state championship.
And
impressed with both teams.
I think you saw the experience of Hanahan having been here last year and won it. I think maybe Emerald came out a little bit flat in some matches. And, you know, it's a big step to jump right into a state final. You know, now that they've had this experience, next year they'll be able to build on that and they'll probably come back a lot stronger. But Hanahan's experience and having been there, I think really won this match for them.
So the championship trophy will head back down to Charleston, South Carolina, where Hanahan wins again here in Columbia, 40-34. We'll be back with the awards presentation ceremony when we return to Dreher High School in Columbia here on the SCHSL Network.
Good job. We'll cut loose now until the next match.
Oh, yeah.
Power flag, Damian Reeves. At the Great job.
And we're not 20.
Hey, good match, sir.
Yes, sir.
Great job, Chris. Great job, sir.
Yep,
good win.
Great job.
Congratulations.
Congratulations to the Hanahan Hawks as they hoist the state championship trophy for the second consecutive time, outlasting Emerald 40-34. So the Hanahan Hawks are your 2012 Class 2A State Wrestling Champions. Folks, don't forget you can get a DVD copy of this championship broadcast by checking out our website at www.schsl.tv. This has been a presentation of the South Carolina High School League and Play On Sports for our entire crew here in Columbia. And for Bill Pierce, I am Birch Antley saying so long. We'll talk to you next time here on the SCHSL Network.